Good morning, everyone. Let's stand together and worship. This is Mary's song of praise. In Luke 1, it says, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. He who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has filled the hungry with good things, and he has helped his servant in remembrance of his mercy, as he has spoken to our fathers, to Abraham, and to all his offspring forever. You.
revolves around your throne. Who can know your glory? So high above, yet slain for us, you alone are worthy. And the praise is yours. And the praise is yours. You're the one we bow before, reigning over us as we lift you up. You will reign
revolves around you. This Christmas season, Father Jesus, it's all about you. And we thank you, Jesus, for coming. We thank you, Jesus, for making a way for us. It's all about you, Jesus. And I pray that it will be all about you in this Christmas season for us. We bless you, Lord. So Jesus, we thank you that you are so great and wonderful. You have changed our lives forever. Thank you for your love. Thank you for coming. Thank you for Christmas. Thank you for carrying us through this year. You have been truly amazing. Thank you, Father, for this time. And Lord, I pray that you would speak to us today. And we commit this day and this time to you. And we bless you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, you may be seated.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, what a great time of worship. 6 days till Christmas. Do you believe it? But there's still plenty of time to enjoy this season, plenty of time to meditate on the goodness of God and just what a great act of mercy it was and humility for what Jesus did. Well, it's so good to worship with you this morning. So good to be with you. And as some of you may know, this is a very special Sunday. It's our family Christmas service. So today we actually get to enjoy a video put together by our very own kids. You'll get to that in a second. I have a few announcements to make first, though, but be excited. I'm really excited to see what they've worked so hard to make for us this morning. So, a couple announcements this morning. Before I get into that, thank you for being here. So glad that you're here. So glad you can join us for this special service. And it's so good to see all the families together. I know, you know, we usually have our kids separate in the kids' ministry, and they're blessed there, and it's a wonderful time, but it's also such a special blessing to see our kids in the service today. So we're grateful for everyone who's here and everyone who's going to be watching at home, and it's just so blessed to be together. If it's your first time being with us this morning, we welcome you, we thank you for being here, and we want to get in touch with you, so make sure that if you haven't caught the eye of one of our staff member yet, make sure to do that. We'll fill out a little connection card for you so that we can bless you with a gift, so we can get to know you, but also for contact tracing. So thank you for being here. We just want to bless you and just want to thank you for coming today. I want to thank you as well for your giving. You have been so faithful this year, and we want to just thank you for that. And we want to again encourage you as we come to the end of the year. If you haven't given yet, we would strongly encourage you to do so. That can be done online at our website by clicking Give, texting any amount to 84321. So we've got two options there. You can e-transfer us at give@waypointchurch.cc. And as always, you can give physically at the welcome desk there. So thank you for your giving. And I want to give a very special thank you for something that you guys really stepped up to the plate for this year. And that was our plentiful Christmas giving drive. As some of you may know, we had the opportunity to give to some families at Harry Miller Middle School. That's always a tongue twister, but I got it. We had the opportunity to give to some families there who weren't able to put together. You know, this has been a hard year for a lot of people. They weren't able to afford a Christmas meal. So we were able to provide 11 families with full Christmas meals with all the fixings, everything you can imagine in those Christmas meals. And it was it's just awesome. Because of your giving, we were able to meet the needs of those 11 families. So give yourselves a hand. That's awesome. All right, you're almost done having to listen to me speak, but there's one more thing before the kids' video comes. We have, as some of you may know, we did our online gingerbread house competition, and we have our results. The results are in. And actually, I'm going to mask for this part. I'm going to see if you guys can still hear me. Are we good? Am I muffled a little bit, or am I good? All right, perfect. So the reason I'm asking is because we're going to ask the families who are giving some prizes away to send a representative up or to come up to the stage. We just want to have everyone see your gingerbread houses and see you as well. So everyone, give me a bit of a drum roll here. We have a couple of honorable mentions, by the way, I should say. So our first honorable mention, because there were a lot. Sorry, I made you drum roll too early. That's totally on me. We had so many great gingerbread houses. It was tough to pick a winner, and it was even tough to pick honorable mentions here. So we ended up having a couple extra prizes here. So, okay, real drum roll this time. We have our first honorable mention. We have the Creklo family. Can we get a representative from the Creklo family to come up to the stage? Awesome. Great job, you guys. Come on up. Give me an elbow bump here. Good job here. Thanks. Awesome, awesome. Congratulations. Give them a hand. All right, we've got another honorable mention here. Oh, did we see their house yet? Let's put their house up on the screen. There we go. Look at that lovely house. We've got a nativity set there. Really creative there. Well done, guys. All right, our next house. another honorable mention here, drum roll please, is the Dukes family. Come on up. Can we get a representative or two from the... Yeah, there we go. And can I get an elbow bump for Miss Felicity and Bronwyn? Awesome. Yeah, there you go, guys. Give them a hand. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that train. Look at the snowman. Very, very creative. All right. I'm going to need the biggest drum roll of all for our winners this year. Our winners are the Payne family. Give them a big hand. Yeah, come on up, Nathan. Give me an elbow bump. Yeah, awesome. Look at that. You got the usage of the Kit Kats. We've got the train out of the edible Lego blocks. Wonderful job. Give them a big hand. Thank you very much to everyone who participated. That was great. It was so fun for us to look at all of those and to see you guys participating. So thank you so much. And that is all for me. Pastor Carly's going to come up and give it a little intro before we get into the kids' video. Bless you. Have a great Sunday.
All right. Good morning. So today's our family Christmas service. This year, we did something a little bit different with the kids. We actually did a little bit more recording this year, but not as much videotaping. So this year, the kids were acting as narrators and voice actors. And our very own Sophie put together a lot of artwork and animations that we could make basically a Bible story or like a storybook of the Nativity story. So without further ado, here it is.
Our story begins a long, long time ago. Actually, it goes even farther than that.
This story began with the very first people, Adam and Eve.
When God created them, they were happy, free, and full of life. In fact, they ate from what was called the tree of life.
God loved Adam and Eve and even walked with them in the Garden of Eden.
He had only given them one rule. He said, "You must not eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, for when you do, you will surely die."
Unfortunately, Adam and Eve just couldn't resist eating from the tree of knowledge of good and evil after having been tempted by the serpent.
This is where everything started to fall apart. They tried to hide what they had done, but God already knew.
God wouldn't let them live in their sins forever, though. He still loved them, and he had a plan to save them.
For years and years after this, God's power was demonstrated through his chosen people.
There was war, victory, famine, captivity, deliverance, and prophecy.
God's people struggled to remain loyal to him, often turning to the idolatrous ways of others.
And through it all, God was working out his plan to save us. Everything that happened, happened so that this story can take place.
The story of Jesus' birth.
In a land far from here lived a young woman named Mary.
Mary was engaged to marry a man named Joseph. He was a descendant of King David.
This detail is important, but we won't get into it today.
One day, an angel called Gabriel appeared to Mary.
"Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you."
Mary couldn't believe what she was hearing and seeing.
The expression on her face must have made that obvious because the angel said,
"Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end.
But how can this be, for I have been with no man?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Nothing is impossible with God.
I am the Lord's servant. May this happen as you have told me.
When Joseph came to find out that Mary was with child, he was surprised and confused.
After all, how could he be expected to believe that this had truly happened by the power of the Holy Spirit?
Because he was a good man, Joseph decided that he would divorce Mary quietly.
But everything changed when an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. She will give birth to a son. You should give him the name Jesus. And he will save God's people from their sins.
All this has happened to fulfill what the Lord has said through the prophet Isaiah.
The virgin will be a child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us.
When Joseph woke up, he went to do just as the Lord has told him.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman Empire. Everyone was to travel to their hometowns to register. So Joseph and Mary began their journey to Bethlehem, the city of David, because Joseph belonged to the house of David.
When Joseph and Mary arrived at the Bethlehem, it came time for the baby to be born.
Joseph, I think it's time the baby's coming.
Okay, don't panic. Let's go to the nearest inn. We can settle there for a baby to be born. Excuse me, sir. Is there a room that we could stay in for the night?
Sorry, friend. All of our rooms are full. Come back tomorrow if you're still interested.
Tomorrow will be too late. See, my wife is having a baby and we need a place where she can rest.
I suppose you're in a little pickle, huh? There's no room in the inn, but you can see yourself back there.
It wasn't quite what they had expected, but it would have to do. They settled down in the stable, and soon after, Mary gave birth to a baby boy.
Just as the angel said, they gave him the name Jesus. Mary wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger.
Meanwhile, in fields nearby,
hey, are you seeing what I'm seeing?
When the shepherds kept watch over their flock by night, an angel in the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men, on whom his favor rests.
Then the angels left and returned to heaven.
Let's go to Bethlehem to see what's happened.
They hurried up and found Mary, Joseph, and the baby, who was laying in the manger. After they had seen him, they couldn't wait to spread the news.
Have you been heard of the Savior that's been born?
There is a baby lying in a manger. The Lord told us about him, and it was true. We saw him.
You have to come see. He's so cute, and he's going to save us.
All were amazed at the news they spread. When the shepherds returned to Mary, Joseph, and the little baby Jesus, they were glorifying God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Jesus was born in the unlikeliest of places. The people of Israel expected a great king, not a little baby. the most rulers, they probably pictured him with wealth not being born in a shelter for animals. But that's the kind of thing Jesus is all about. God's kingdom was first revealed in these dirty places among the poor. Because Jesus came to bring salvation to all and to turn our world order upside down.
For unto us a child has been born,
unto us a son is given,
and the government will be on his shoulders,
and he will be called
Wonderful Counselor,
Mighty God,
Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Isaiah 9:6.
Awesome. Didn't they do a great job? Good job. And can we hear it for Sophie? Thank you so much, Sophie. A lot of hours were poured into those images, but I think it worked out. I think it was worth it. I think it looked really great. And kids, you guys did a great job. Love hearing your voices telling this amazing story that, as we heard at the end, God revealed his kingdom in these dirty and poor places because he turned the world order upside down. That's what Jesus did. He turned everything on its head. He confused people. He surprised people. He did the unexpected. And that's why we praise him. That's why we serve him. That's why we are all saved today, because he came for all, right? All right, so that was our presentation for today. The Family Christmas service is never a long one. So from here, Pastor Tim is going to come, and he's going to pray for us. And I would like at this time for all the kids are going to follow me out into the cafe.
I'd like to ask Lydia and the worship team to come. They're going to lead us in a song as we're leaving in a few moments. I'm gonna tell you all about kind of what to do on the way out in just a moment, but I want to pause before we conclude our service today to just acknowledge that, you know, something I learned a long, long time ago and never forgot is that it's never just another Sunday. You know, every Sunday when you gather, there's people. Doesn't matter if there's two or there's 200 or 2,000 in the room. That's really not the point. Because when you gather people, there are needs, there are hurts, there are challenges. And so we want to just take a moment before we go today, and I just want to offer a prayer for you. So the word, just maybe play something softly, and I just want to ask you today, who might be here that just has a need in your heart? And I wonder who that might be. You never know. Some of you have spoken to today, and you have conversation, and things seem fine. But sometimes underneath that conversation, there's a need. Some of you know who I mean by our friend Lloyd. He's not with us today. We're praying for Lloyd, believing God for his hand. For Marilyn, who is here, her faith is strong and in the Lord. We're just thanking God for his goodness. Amen. We're praying. We're believing. We're trusting. We're leaning heavily on the Lord. And maybe you're leaning heavily on the Lord for something in your life. This is all I'm going to do before I pray. If you're here today and there's a need in your life, you'd just like to be included in this prayer. Maybe it's for you. Maybe it's something you're going through. Maybe it's someone that you love. They're going through something. But I'd love to pray for you today. And this beautiful story that was told today about a God who so loved the world, a God who loved us that much, so loved the world that he sent Jesus. We know the rest of the story, not only to be born, but to live his life and then to sacrifice himself so that we could be forgiven, so that we could be healed, so that we could be blessed, so that we could know eternal life. So can I pray for you? If you're here today, that God that was talked about in the story, that we've sung about, worshiped today, loves you deeply. And
I'd love to just include you in this prayer. If you just slip up your hand, I'll just acknowledge it. I'm not going to call you out, and I'm not going to embarrass you. I'm not going to pray for you by name even, but you just say, Lord, see my hand, see my faith. Pastor, pray. There's a need in my home or in my heart. Is there anyone here? God bless you. You, yes. Okay. Yeah. Now, there are a number of hands. Anybody else? Yeah. God bless you. Every hand a story. If you could only know some of the stories represented by these hands raised. Real challenges, real dilemmas, real needs. So let's agree together. Father God, you are a God of amazing ability. And as it was said in our story today, with God, all things are possible. And I pray for the miraculous today for those in the room who have needs. I pray in the name of Jesus that for those who need healing, I pray right now into that body may be right here, that person right here in this room, or maybe at a distance. But Lord, I pray the virtue of Jesus upon them and within them, and that, Lord, every disease and every infirmity and every sickness, Lord, would just leave, and that health and healing and wholeness would come. Lord, this is a season our messages have focused around peace. And for some today that raise their hand, likely there's a need for peace. There's turmoil of some sort. There's need. There's decisions to make, Lord. There's barriers that need to be removed, Lord. Father, I pray for them right now for the peace of God that passes human understanding to just flood their hearts as we trust you, God. Thank you that we can trust you with our very lives, Lord. Thank you that no matter what these needs are today, and no matter what every hand and every family represents, Lord, there is nothing that you can't do. It's not too hard, and we can trust you today. We choose to, in the name of Jesus, we choose to trust you. We pray your peace. And so we thank you for that, Lord. And God, we pray for our children. We are so blessed. Thank you for Pastor Carly. Thank you for Sophie. Thank you for all who serve our kids. Thank you for our children and their families. I just pray this will be a beautiful, blessed season for them. May early in their life they come to understand that Christmas is not about gifts. It's not about money. It's not about materialism. Lord, it's not about decoration, although it's all a part of a celebration. May they understand early in life that Christmas is the story of a Savior being born, and we're grateful. We give thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Thank you for letting me pray for you today. Well, we have a special gift for you. The kids are out there in the cafe, and I think that that divider is going to be pulled back, and we want everybody to go out. We have a special gift for you, for every adult. The kids have some other gifts that they're going to be given, but for every adult that's here today, we have a Waypoint mug for you. It has some hot chocolate in it. It has a candy cane. It has a Waypoint pen and a Waypoint magnet, and I'm not sure what else might have made its way in there, but it's a Merry Christmas gift from Waypoint Church to all of you. We wish you a Merry Christmas. I hope you're able to join us on Christmas Eve. But if not, please know that you're in our hearts, you're loved, and we wish you a Merry, Merry Christmas. Let's all stand together. And Lydia's going to lead us in this song. And as she sings, we're dismissed. And why don't we just kind of gradually, maybe we'll just kind of go from one side to the other, because we can't all get into the cafe at once. So starting on my right, we're going to kind of dismiss a bit. I'm not going to kind of dismiss, but you can kind of tell when the next section is kind of gone. So those of you on my right, you can go first to the cafe to get your gift and greet. If you want to hang out here a bit, that's fine. And hey, listen up. Just everybody, so you know, we're not setting up chairs for cafe this week, okay? No play cafe, so chairs can stay. Okay? Merry Christmas, everybody. God bless you.